Okay, I'm going to be talking to you about how to use a heat sleeve to build up your grip. First, you need a racket, you need a heat sleeve, and you need some kind of heat gun. I'm going to use a Supermax Conair hair dryer, very fancy. These come in two different sizes. The black one will build it up a full grip size, so for example, from a 4 3/8 to 4.5, which is, I believe what we're doing here, is a 4 3/8 to go to a 4.5. There's a white grip that'll do half sizes. So if you're looking for a half size, those are out there. They're white and they're a little thinner. They're a little more temperamental to put on. You'll see me put this one on in a second. But the white ones, just to warn you, you really need to even out the heat because they like to fold back on top of each other because they're a little stiffer. But what you want to do to start is slide the heat sleeve over the grip. Okay, now see how there's the end of the grip here? That's where you're going to cut your the sleeve. That's where you're going to trim it up. So you want to be sure that this is a good ways above it because it's going to shrink down a little bit. Okay, so a good ways above it, and you're ready to start. Now make sure that you're not too far down here, okay, because this is where you're going to start heating. So you want to be sure to have enough to cover the whole butt cap down here. Okay, so just a little bit over. All right, it's going to get kind of loud just because the heat gun's going. But you're going to want to heat from there to there, and you're going to want to keep the heat moving. Don't just hold the heat in one spot. Okay, if you hold the heat in one spot, it could melt. It may shrink unevenly. You want it to be nice and even, and you want to start from one end to the other, from the butt cap to the top end. Now, I really don't know why. But if you're ever taking a certification test, that's how they're going to expect you to do it, is from the butt cap to the throat. Okay? So here we go. It's getting loud.
I let you down. Let me pick you up. I let you down. Let me climb up you to the top so I can see the view from up there, tangled in your hair. I let you down. I have no lid upon my head, but if I did, you could look inside and see what's on my mind. You could look inside and see what's on my mind. I let you down.
Okay, now once you've got it heat shrunk down all the way, you want to go over it a lot with the heat just to make sure that's nice and smooth. And I hope you can see that the bevels are kind of subdued. They're not as clear and defined as they were. That's going to happen. That's why you should never build up using this method, using more than two sleeves. Otherwise, the bevels, they basically just disappear. I mean, they're there, but they're not as defined as they need to be. But after you get it shrunk down, what we need to do is trim it. Okay, take a knife or a razor or anything sharp and trim the bottom part off. And then this top part. Now the top part's going to be the trickiest. When you trim around and you get it cut around, you have to get that sleeve off. And the way that I do it is I'll stick the knife just underneath and just kind of pop out a little bit and cut my way up. Instead of going like this and risking cutting the frame, it's a little risky. But at the top, you trim it down to where the grip ends. Now it's easy on this racket because it starts with this balsa woody foam kind of material, so there's a clearly defined line, and most rackets have some kind of clearly defined line where the rack or where the yoke ends and the handle begins. But you just want to trim to where you stop your grip, essentially. But the bottom you want to trim to within a 1/16 of an inch of the bevel, or of the butt cap end, rather. So just want to work your way around. And I'll do that real quick and I'll show you the end product here in a sec. All right, this is the finished product. Can't really see it too well, but it's flush up against the bottom of the butt cap within 1/16 of an inch, and then up against the line at the top for where the grip goes. And then all you have to do is install your grip. You install it right on top. And that's it. That's how you build up a grip with a heat sleeve. Thank you.